of it.
It's so intelligent, so sassy. Oh,
it is so sassy.
Full of brilliant anecdotes.
Oh, brilliant anecdotes.
And just reading the book, I was like, oh, I guess that's why I'm single.
Mystery solved.
Personally, I cannot wait to get out on the town and try some of these tricks myself.
But there's a but, right?
We feel like it's missing something.
Such as?
It's missing...
you.
Me?
Yes. It's missing your love story.
My love story?
The book needs a personal touch. It needs your personal angle on dating. Well, for us to be on board with this project, we would really like to see a final chapter of your love story.
Nina.
We can't market a book about how to find love written by someone who hasn't found it herself.
So what, you want me to just get a boyfriend so I can get my book published, or?
We just need a final chapter with your very own happy ever after.
We know our audience. They want firsthand accounts. They want real life. That's how you get them.
And you're gonna go from dating coach to best-selling author. Trust us.
Okay, what does this...
Or a famous socialite would be good, huh? Or how about that famous house fiddler? Oh, my God.
It's outrageous.
Absolutely outrageous.
That I need a man to get my book published. Is this how feminism dies, Tess? I am tempted to just ditch the entire book deal out of principle. Goodbye, Mike and Jane.
Well, in theory, you should totally do that, but they're the best. They know what they're doing. You even said it yourself. They launch careers, and Nina, this is your dream. So you're gonna find a boyfriend, and you're gonna get your book deal.
Yeah, but I love being single.
Okay. The only people who say they love being single are people who don't know how to smash it.
Come on, Nina, you've been single forever.
It's about time you found a love for yourself. It's tragic New York's top dating coach is single.
Oh, so tragic. So tragic that I'm a free, thriving, independent woman.
But who says you can't be free, thriving, independent, and in a loving relationship?
Stop quoting my book at me. What would I even write my final chapter about?
Write about your happy ever after with your new boyfriend.
I don't have a boyfriend, so go get a boyfriend.
Taz.
La, 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 la,
Taz!
La, 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 la. I can't hear you.
Oh.
La, 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 la.
Hello?
Hello. Am I speaking with a Miss Bauer?
You are? Who am I speaking to?
Good afternoon, Miss Bauer. Ask if you may be able to come to us for a consultation.
I'm sorry, you're the butler for the royal family of Montrovia?
That's correct.
Bradley, is this you?
No, it's Charles, the butler to the royal family of Montrovia.
Very funny, Bradley.
No, this isn't Bradley. This is Charles.
Okay, Charles. If you're the butler for the royal family of Montrovia, who's your attorney general?
Tom Huxtable.
Tom? What does she want with Tom?
Your health secretary.
Celia Steele.
Okay, say the word H-E-R-B.
Herb. Oh, Montrovia, daughters of snowy fields.
Okay, you actually are the butler for the royal family of Montrovia. Sorry, I thought you were...
Bradley.
Who's Bradley?
You wanted me to come to Montrovia for consultation?
Montrovia House. It's two blocks from the Rockefeller Center.
That makes a lot more sense. And when and who would I be consulting with?
We'd prefer not to say over the phone.
Today at 5. 5 o'clock today, no later.
How does today at 5 p.m. sound?
Make a little exception.
Perfect. We look forward to meeting with you.
She's going to come?
She's going to come.
Oh, excellent. You're the best.
Yes, I am. Miss Bauer, Charles, we spoke on the phone. How do you do? This way, please. The prince will be with you shortly. May I bring you some tea while you wait?
Coffee. Black. Wait, the prince?
Perfect. Is that for me?
Okay, I'll get one of those two, Charles.
I'm Freddy.
I'm Nina. Nice to meet you.
We have actually already met.
We have?
Yes, last night in the cocktail bar. You gave me your card. I was on a disastrous date.
Right. You were the love vampire.
I beg your pardon?
Your date was telling you that she felt like you were sucking her soul out.
Oh, you really need to stop doing that, buddy.
Well, I was only trying to connect with the woman.
You were on the verge of telling her that you were in love with her.
Well, if it's love at first sight.
Even so.
Save it for the proposal a year down the line.
What?
Sorry. Freddy, you just really shouldn't tell a woman exactly how you feel on the first date.
Well, what can I say? I'll wear my heart on my sleeve.
Yeah. That's
not gonna fly in Manhattan.
Nina, please take a seat. Let's get right to it. My mother and father, the king and queen, have decided it's time for me to settle down and get married. And while the person that they've chosen for me to marry is lovely, she's not the love of my life. And frankly, nor am I the love of hers. She's more like a sister, and I don't want to marry my sister.
Who does?
So, after a huge, huge royal row, my mother short, it's been
total train wreck.
Nina, this is my last chance to find true love. I need your help. I don't want to be married just for the sake of being married. I want
fireworks, sparks, the Romeo and Juliet story.
Exactly.
Besides the exile and double suicide, of course. Of course.
I'm sorry. Who are you?
It's Edward. Ignore him. Nina, will you guide me through the ruthlessly savage Manhattan dating scene and help me find my princess?
While I appreciate the call, and I would normally jump at this
opportunity.
Never mind. We're on.
We are?
Yes, I am going to help you find your princess.
Huzzah! Oh, and sorry. Edward, Nina, Edward. He's my right-hand man and the person who you'll be working with.
Yes, hello.
I'm sorry, working with?
Well, yes, Edward is a royal matchmaker. He's the best in the business. And you'll be working alongside him.
Freddy. Freddy, I work alone.
Okay.
In this kind of work, it's personal, delicate, intimate.
I know.
So three's a crowd.
I totally understand that. It's just, I'm going to politely ask that you work alongside Edward.
Why?
He has to be here to vet the women I date. It was the one condition that my mother allowed me to come out here alone.
Well, that's demeaning.
I feel fine about it.
For me, it's my career, my calling. I don't work well with others.
Trust me. You guys will work great together.
You cannot have two people coaching you at the same time. It's impossible.
Edward isn't a coach, so you do the matchmaking as well.
So what will he do?
His role will be purely ceremonial. You'll run the show, but for the sake of keeping my mother happy, Edward will also be here. Please?
I'll do it.
Hurrah!
But I run the show.
Oh, absolutely.
Freddy, I run the show.
Right.
Well, fantastic.
It's agreed. You're both officially the Royal Montrovian dating team.
Excellent. Should we get matching tracksuits?
Ooh, should we?
No.
Right. Nina's going to lead the way into the front.
I have a feeling we'll get along tremendously.
We will, if you stay out of my way.
Thank you, Charles.
Terrifying lady.
Yes.
Nina, you promised not to take on any new clients.
It's the Prince of Montrovia.
I don't care if it's Ryan Reynolds. You promised to focus on finding yourself a boyfriend.
He is gonna be my boyfriend.
What?
They wanted me to date someone impressive, so I'm gonna date someone impressive.
Okay, but are you even attracted to him?
He's cute. I mean, he's someone I could learn to fall in love with. And then once we... And then you and I can go off to Mexico together.
But then how are you going to date the prince if you're coaching him?
I'm gonna pretend to coach him and then secretly seduce him.
It's totally unethical, outrageous, beneath you, and frankly quite devious even for you.
It is.
How are you going to seduce the prince with the other dude lingering around?
I'm going to work around this royal matchmaker and seduce the prince behind his back.
Sweet, pure, innocent love.
Wish me luck.
Last night was a lot of fun. Morning, Nina. How are you today?
Good.
I'm doing great, too, actually. Yeah, I had a really great night last night.
Business or pleasure?
If it isn't the royal dating team, good morning. What's on the agenda today?
So I've actually updated our little list of...
As the native New Yorker, I should probably vet that list.
Oh, that list is well vetted. Trust me, okay? This list is comprised of some of the most impressive eligible women in all of Manhattan.
Uh-huh. No, no, no. Married. No. She is a notorious freeloader. Sorry. She is sleeping with half of Manhattan. Not for you, Freddy. She's being investigated for fraud. Great. She's having an affair with a senator. Oh, maybe. Oh, no. No. Huh.
I spent all night on this.
Oh, did you? That's so sweet. Freddy would be better. How Freddy is going to date.
No point in having a list if they all leave 5 minutes after I open my mouth.
Exactly. So, let's get to work.
Righty-ho.
So we're going to start with the basics, introducing ourselves and flirting. So how about I be the woman at the bar and you seduce me?
Hi. I'm so sorry to interrupt, but you happen to be the most beautiful woman in the world.
Oh, okay.
What? I thought that was charming.
The most beautiful woman in the world? Come on, let's just bring it down a notch, okay? And try again?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, gonna stop you right there.
Right, yeah, sorry, I'm feeling a bit nervous
it's
now,
okay.
So.
It's okay. How about this? How about we just flip the script? Okay, you be the woman, I will be the prince.
Perfect.
Okay. Okay. Hey.
Hello.
Do you have the time?
Yes, it's,
Oh, don't worry about it.
What? Where are you going?
Hmm?
You just asked me for the time, and now you're turning away, and...
Oh. Sound, kind of direct, but... The scent, it's beautiful. I think it would be a great gift for my sister. Let me buy you a drink. What's it called? See?
I see.
Right?
Yeah. It's gets the awkwardness out.
Exactly.
Yes, it was very good, but I have a note.
A note? What note?
In my humble opinion, it's better to make it a little bit more about her and a little less about the time. I think you kind of want to make someone feel like they're the only other person in the room, you know? May I?
Good. Oh, please.
All right, somewhere where you know you'll be able to be in her eye line and she will be in yours. Once I find that spot, I ground myself, take a breath, I'm comfortable in my own skin.
So sorry to interrupt. Are you saying that out loud, or...?
This is my internal monologue, Freddy.
Right, Shakespeare, nice.
I'm calm, I'm centered. I wait for her to see me. 75% of all communication is nonverbal, Freddy. Remember that. I let her magnificence wash over me.
That makes me feel magnificent.
I take her in now, like the priceless work of art that she is.
There's a word for that. Objectification.
This moment is fully saturated. I begin to close the distance between the two of us, making sure not to rush. And it's like we know each other from somewhere before, another lifetime, perhaps.
It really does feel like that.
Hey.
Hey.
I'm sorry, I couldn't take my eyes off of you. Do we know each other from somewhere?
Okay.
Can I get you a drink? Maybe we can figure it out. Somewhere there, in that vibe,
that was insanely
good. You were so there. It was amazing. Me too, you were. The watch thing, it was inspired. Yes.
I swear, Taz, this guy is so obnoxious.
Really?
Yeah, he thinks he's Ryan Gosling.
Ugh, annoying. I know exactly the kind of guys you're talking about. What's Prince Freddy like?
He's, kind of cute.
Hmm.
And charming. In a bumbling British Hugh Grant kind of way.
But wait, I don't get it. Why is the prince employed you if he's already got this Gosling wannabe coaching him?
Oh, he's not a coach. He's a royal matchmaker.
What's the difference?
I don't know, he finds appropriate people for the royals to date. Okay. This thing a whole lot harder than it needs to be.
You need to find a way to get the prince on his own then.
I am way ahead of you.
Oh.
That was also a pleasure, in case you're interested.
It isn't the greatest dating coach of all time.
I know that I gave you a lot to digest yesterday, so I just want to let that settle. And today, we are going to focus on your wardrobe.
What's wrong with my wardrobe?
You come with me. You can have the day off. This requires a bit of a woman's touch, so you can just chill.
Well, actually, if we're talking about a new wardrobe, I happen to know the best guy in town.
Really?
That's kind, but we'll be fine.
No. I really must insist. Okay, Oz is the best. He dresses all the big names. If anyone's gonna dress Freddy, I think it's gotta be him. I'll give him a call right now. Oz, Edward, I have the Prince of Montrovia for you.
Eddie!
Oz, how you doing, old friend?
If I had a tail, I would wag it.
Oh, good. This is...
the prince. She will be mostly feeding you luxury foodstuffs.
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
Right. Oz is the best in the business, Freddy. He'll have you looking like Clooney in no time.
He's actually also dressed Clooney.
Oh. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. You are a prince. What you need is a wardrobe that is dashing, yet understated. What are the royal colors of Montrovia?
White, pink, and green.
We'll make that work. Okay, now strip.
Oh, right.
What was that about objectification?
Oh, you mean appreciation?
Touché.
guess this is not going as planned at all. I haven't written anything. I haven't made any progress with the prince, and now he looks like Jude Law. And half of Manhattan is going to want to go on a date with him.
Which, to be fair, is what he's employed you for.
But it's the publishers. Don't say or do anything crazy.
I'm just polishing a wine glass.
Jane, Mike, how are you?
We're doing well, but more importantly, how are you doing?
Yes. Any developments in the final chapter?
Mm-hmm. It's going really well.
Really?
Yes. I'm actually, I'm dating someone, so just...
Fantastic. Who are you dating?
The Prince of Monrovia. Hello?
Oh, I'm sorry. We're just a little confused. Did you just say you're dating the Prince of Monrovia?
I am. Is that the kind of impressive person you were thinking about?
Nina, this would guarantee your book being published. Do you really think you'll end up together?
Definitely.
Okay. Well, don't let us hold you up. We look forward to the final chapter.
Great. Yes, it's gonna be finished really soon. Right?
No.
Miss Bauer, I wasn't aware you were coming this morning.
Well, I aimed a surprise. Where's Freddy?
Say hi.
Hello. Was that it, or?
Well, I was thinking of maybe going for a walk in the park or visiting some galleries. I'm not sure if you're in the mood for some culture, but galleries are a perfect place to find princesses.
Oh, good to know. And I would have loved to, but I've already made plans with Edward, so.
What?
Oh, here he is now.
What are you doing here? It's our day off.
I could ask you the same.
Well, I was gonna take Freddy princess hunting. What about you?
Then.
What party?
All right, Freddy, you're gonna love this, okay? This is one of the most elite parties in all of Manhattan. Yeah? This place is filled with some of the most impressive eligible people in town.
I've never heard of it.
Like I said, now when I walk into a party, Freddy, I say to myself, all the women in here want me.
Right. Hmm. Sorry, it's funny.
Pay no mind to her, yeah? Try it, Freddy. All these women want me.
All these women want you.
No, Freddy, no.
Freddy, don't do that. It's lame.
My track record speaks for itself. Okay, would you just please? All right, Freddy?
Mm-hmm.
Try again.
Maybe. All the women in here.
Oh my gosh! Oh, I'm sorry.
I just tripped on the floor.
Freddy, you just keep the vibe going.
Why don't you follow me? Here we are.
A bit out of the way, aren't we?
It's perfect.
Perfect?
Yeah. When you're dating in Manhattan, you don't want to be on display like a old box of cereal. You want... Yes. Exactly.
So what, I just stand here and wait for them to find me?
Yeah, that's right.
What if they don't?
Maybe they already have.
I'm not sure I understand.
You look so good in your suit.
Thank you.
Brings out something in your...
mind.
Eyes.
What about them?
There's so much soul in them.
I don't know. They're just brown.
You're so funny. You know, it's so crazy to me that you needed to hire a dating coach. You're brilliant just as you are.
In your experience, how do you find one?
Well, sometimes it's just the person right in front of you.
What are you two doing?
I'm being obscure and precious and impossible to find, like the heart of the ocean.
Come back to the party, please. Yeah, I think I found the perfect woman for you.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yes, come on. You, no, stay. Thank you.
What does she do?
I have a really good feeling about this one for you.
Yeah, put that down, put that down.
Okay, come here. Do you see her through the crowd there?
Where? She's stunning. Who is she?
Her name's Jessica Morrison. She's a Knick girl. Socialite and daughter of a billionaire maple syrup tycoon.
Sweet.
All right, go talk to her. Yep. Oh, he's doing so good. Oh, he's almost as smooth as me.
So, like, not smooth? Oh, I'll take that. Thank you.
Guess who just got Rachel Cox's phone number?
I'd be surprised if it was real.
It's real, okay? Boy, jealousy does not look good on you.
I'm not jealous.
Hey, nothing's stopping you.
We should get back to Freddy.
Hey!
Can I grab your number? Perhaps we should go for dinner?
Yeah.
Ordered a few, Perfect, thank you.
Yeah.
There we go. Thank you so much. Well, it was so lovely meeting you, Jessica.
Lovely meeting you.
Stay safe. Okay. You take care.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
How'd you do, Blair?
Guess what, guys? I got her number!
Yeah, you did.
And we arranged a dinner date. I'm so excited. I can't believe I'm going on a date with this beautiful, intelligent woman.
It makes perfect sense, Freddy.
I mean, that's going to be a disaster, though.
Why would you say that?
I guess you better get practicing.
Okay, but with who?
Tell me about Controlia. Tell me about your home.
Well, what would you like to know?
I don't know anything. What's your fondest childhood memory?
Ooh, good question. It has to be the first time I met Millie. Yeah, first time meeting Millie. Oh, she was magnificent.
Mm. Who was Millie, your first girlfriend?
No, my first horse.
Oh.
Yeah, I'll never forget it. She, it was a crisp. And my mother and father took me outside. And there she was, just standing there in all her glory, with the steam rising off her. And from that moment onwards, we had a really special one. I love that horse so much.
I can see that.
Oh, hey, you two. Sorry, I'm late. The subway was just...
What are you doing here?
What do you mean? It's Freddy's practice date.
Unless Freddy wants to join the polyamorous community, it's a...
To be right... Yeah, right. Right here. You two just carry on. Yeah. Act natural.
Sure.
You look really very beautiful, Miss Campbell.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Are you sure that Edward isn't a distraction here?
Oh, no, not at all. Actually, his presence really helps get me in the zone. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much.
Oh.
Ooh. Wow, that looks great.
Mm.
I'm just gonna...
So, tell me, Mina, Antipasti as well as an artist. Mm. Mm-hmm. Sorry, Nina, am I boring you?
No, you're not.
Do you want to go dance?
We haven't covered dancing yet.
Let's cover it now.
Oh. We'll be back.
You are not too bad, Freddy, you little liar.
Well.
And it's kind of sexy.
Not if you do it to hip-hop. I got booed off the dance floor on the Lower East Side the other day.
Huh. Well, maybe we should get you some lessons.
You've got a rogue eyelash.
Oh. Make a wish.
So good, Freddy. So good.
Could you just give us a little space?
No.
I'm gonna run to the washroom. I'll be back in just a moment.
Oh, Freddy.
Oh, right.
Yeah, you can't just leave a woman alone on the dance floor, okay? If this was a real date, she'd be going home with me now instead of you.
Yeah, in your dreams, buddy.
Would you care to cut in?
It would be my honor.
Thank you.
We don't have to dance, it's okay.
Oh, come on. Dance with me.
It's fine.
What, you scared you won't be able to keep things professional? You don't really enjoy working with me, is all.
You're fine.
Okay, here's a question for you. Do you advise your clients to kiss someone on the first date?
If they're feeling it, Do you not?
No, not for my male clients anyways. You know, I think it's best if they wait till the fourth date.
The fourth date?
Yeah.
Why?
I think women appreciate it if you take the time to get to know them first. I think they like to connect emotionally before physically.
Mm-hmm. It's so nice to hear what women want. If I went on an amazing date with someone who I connected with and there was a spark and they made me laugh, then I would want them to kiss me on the first date.
Really?
Yeah.
Even say in this scenario, if he was to make you wait to the second date, could that possibly have you yearning for him more?
No, not necessarily, because if this guy didn't kiss me on this amazing date, then it might mean that he's, you know, not spontaneous or insecure, and I would lose interest.
That's interesting.
It's following robotic dating moves.
Fair enough. I still think it serves my male clients to wait till date four.
I'm sure you wait till date four to kiss a woman.
Well, no. But then again, I'm not most of my clients. I'm a pro.
Am I interrupting something?
No. It's good to have you back.
May I?
Please. Thank you for the dance, Nina.
I've got a very big question.
Okay.
Are you more of a Friends or Seinfeld kind of gal?
Oh, that's actually a very good date question. Ooh. I'm obviously a Seinfeld person.
What?
Don't tell me you prefer Friends.
Well, it's got more heart. I've had such a nice date tonight, thank you. Where's Edward?
Probably off somewhere trying to get lucky.
Sounds about right.
It's really nice to finally get you alone. Yeah, I'd like that.
Great. Me too. Well, good night.
Night.
Well done, Freddy. You smashed that out of the park.
Yeah. Oh, you really had her. You did. Oh, but I wouldn't go in for the kiss right at the end like that, though, on the first date, right?
Really?
No. I mean, Nina and I have different opinions about that, don't we, mm-hmm. Nina?
Mm-hmm. I was trying to take a bit of a backseat, you know? Mm-hmm. Play it casual, mm-hmm. just like you taught me.
Yes, right.
Worked pretty well?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it would.
Wow. I'm really impressed with myself. So.
Yes, you should be.
Well, good night, Nina.
Good night.
Yes, good. You were such a good sport. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes.
As well.
Shall we?
Yes.
Yeah. Get home safe.
I can't tell you how annoying it was. We were literally about to kiss. I was so close to closing the deal, and Edward just popped up out of the bushes and ruined it.
But it was a pretend date, right?
He was totally gonna kiss me.
Are you sure?
Yes, trust me. If it wasn't for Edward, we would be in my apartment right now, making out. What does he want now?
Is that Edward?
Yes. Go away.
He's calling you late. Interesting.
Shush, hold on. What?
What a polite way to answer your phone.
Sorry, I was on the other line. What would you like?
I was just wondering if you wanted to get together for lunch tomorrow to maybe go over the notes from tonight's date.
I don't think we need to do that. I think he did well.
Always room for...
That's a good idea.
Bye.
But in all honesty, I think he's doing very well.
He's transformed insanely fast.
Yes, he has.
I wonder if I hadn't interrupted the both of you last night, if you would have kissed him.
You're serious?
Mm-hmm. Oh, don't worry. I probably would have kissed him, too.
I was going to pull away after the last second.
Yeah, sure look like that. Look like you're about ready to play tonsil tennis.
You know, I'm actually more of a football gal. Ethics, you know?
Right. Ethics.
I'm sure you've kissed hundreds of your clients.
I wouldn't have the career that I do if I did.
Hmm.
So, what about you?
What about me?
Well, you're single, right?
If this is you trying to hit on me, you should be my next client.
Okay. Well, are you dating? Or?
No, I actually hate dating.
Really? I love going on dates.
Oh, I've been shit, right? Like, you're not just supposed to go on a series of first dates that don't go anywhere.
My dates go places. Trust me.
Yeah. To your bedroom. And then a cab. And then an early morning text, if you remember.
So why don't you like dating?
Because I can see through the good ones. And for the bad ones, I can't help but tell them what they're doing wrong.
You tell your dates what they're doing wrong?
I know. I can't help it. It's my calling.
If we were to go on a date, hypothetically speaking.
No.
Is that a smile?
No. Maybe. Thank you. So, how did you get into this whole matchmaking thing? Did you just have like a Rolodex of former flings you wanted to share with the world?
No, actually, I was engaged.
Oh. Okay, you were engaged.
And it just didn't work out, like a lot of them don't. And I was in a bit of a funk.
I can see it now. Young Edward on the London Eye, looking out into the rain, all sad.
You may not be far off. Anyway, well, I just wasn't quite ready to date yet when I got there. And because I played polo and because I'm so gregarious and charming,
I'm arrogant.
You mean confident?
No, I mean arrogant. Continue.
Well, and because of the polo, I was in with some of the royal circles anyhow, and so I started matchmaking for them, and then I got a call from Freddie's mom.
It all makes sense now.
What makes sense?
Your fear of commitment.
I don't have a fear of commitment.
You're a commitment phobe.
Well, maybe it takes one to know one.
Cheers to that.
Cheers to that. You know, behind that cold and curt exterior of yours, you're actually quite fun.
I know. Thank you. Anyway.
Hey, what do you think about a double date? It's just to help Freddie out a little bit. The sit-down dates get a little intense for the guy, okay? You get stuck in his head, and if we're there, we can help lighten the mood. It's a very good idea, actually.
A double date?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, is this guy hitting on you now?
No, he's dating like a million women.
Mm-hmm, and now trying to make it a million and one.
Mm.
Is he hot?
Mm. He thinks so.
Mm. Have you thought about dating him instead, if he's into you?
Ew, gross.
No?
No, I need to date someone impressive. Plus, he's smug and smarmy and so annoying. This is the type of guy that I tell my clients to run a million miles away from.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I have a crush on the prince.
You sure about that?
He's funny and
square.
He's not. He's lovely and he's very handsome.
But you need more than lovely and handsome. Okay, you're a firecracker. You need chemistry and spark and wit.
I said he's funny. And there is a spark. I'm genuinely into him.
And then why did you agree to the double date with Edward?
Because I am going to use the date to sabotage Jessica's chances with Freddie.
Clever. And kind of ruthless.
Hmm.
Okay, but wait, what is the plan?
Well, she's a Manhattan socialite, so I will just let her be herself. And
not bad. Freddie, not bad.
Oh.
At all. Look at you.
Look dashing. I'm half tempted to whisk you off on a date with me, for real.
So is this a real date for you two, or?
No.
Well, thank you so much for being here for me.
Of course.
Yeah, that's what we're all here for.
I mean, I'm hoping she shows up.
She won't show up. You know, don't make the man anxious.
I'm just managing expectations.
This must be the place to be.
It is?
Oh, because you're here?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
It's you. You will.
Yes.
It's like when Kate met William.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Very bland.
Yes, I'm actually opening a new contemporary art gallery in Williamsburg next week.
Oh.
You should come, Freddie.
I'd love to.
If you're a fan of art, you should really see the collection at the Monrovia Palace. It is exquisite.
I actually have a...
And just take the palace. Well, for that to happen, you'd have to kill both my parents, so I'd really rather you didn't do that. I think it's really great that you're opening up an art gallery.
Well, thank you. I love my job. I'm just so hashtag blessed.
Mm-hmm. Is that sarcasm? Or do you not find it all a little vacuous?
How do you mean?
Well, don't you find it a little empty being an it girl?
Well, I don't consider myself an it girl.
Hmm. What do you call yourself, a celebrity? Socialite?
Celebrolite? I reject the term. It just comes with a lot of baggage.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not being judgmental. I'm just saying for me, I wouldn't really want to have my whole existence rely on, you know, wanting to be famous.
I'm not trying to be famous. I'm just...
Well, and there's nothing wrong with that, though, either, right?
If it's any consolation, Jessica, I'm a prince, My entire existence is purely ceremonial and based off nothing I've ever personally achieved. So I think it's really cool that you're opening an art gallery and hosting charity events. Could be worse, you could be selling shampoo.
The sponsorship, and it's only one.
Oh, of how many?
Two, a dozen, energy drinks, dog biscuits, bleach. That would go over really well at the palace.
Nina, would you mind just helping me?
We'll be right back. Excuse us.
I think it's fantastic that you sell shampoo. I'll buy 4 orders.
Really?
Yes.
I'm playing a part.
Whatever you think you're doing, you are sabotaging what's happening here.
I'm not sabotaging anything.
You are. Wait, you have a do.
I do not.
It would be understandable, I guess. He's charming and he's handsome. Very rich.
I'm not into him. It's a dating coach tactic, okay? I'm testing her.
Okay, well, whatever it is you think you're doing, it's working.
Oh, shit. Look how cute they are. This is perfect, actually. Yeah. We can just sneak out the back and then text them an excuse later. Huh?
Sure. Yep.
Great. Come on.
Freddie, I brought you some New York bagels.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you so much. Oh, wow, they are fresh.
Yes. I feel the need to explain. It's just, you are so wonderful. You are, and you deserve to end up with someone incredible. And I just don't want to see you settle for just anyone.
I promise you I won't.
Good.
Hand on my heart. Jessica's the one.
What?
Nina, I can't tell you how incredible the date was. The conversation flowed so easily. We walked and talked for hours and hours. It was like a scene from a movie. Jessica is my future.
Yes. Anyone who says that is wrong. That's why so many marriages are horrendous.
Well, that doesn't sound quite right.
Well, it is. And the real one is usually someone that you haven't thought about yet.
Oh, I've never heard that perspective.
That's why you're paying me the big bucks, my expert perspective. You can't just run off with the first woman who shows interest in you. You need to be with someone who sees you, who gets you, who loves you.
Wow, you're very good. I see what you're doing. I see your plan, your evil little scheme.
My scheme?
Very, very good. I mean, a little sneaky, but I understand why you charge my family such extortionate rates.
No, Freddie.
No, thank you. Gosh, you really are the greatest dating coach of all time.
Oh! Was I interrupting something?
No, not at all.
Good. I don't need to ask you how the date last night went, because I know from all those texts you were sending me in the wee hours of the night.
Sorry about that.
No, don't be. You're not sending those texts to Jessica, though, right?
No.
No, never mind. Hey, Nina.
Hey.
Oh, I've also had a great idea for a second date. Black tie cocktail event. Working the whole royal angle, not so bad, right?
Oh, martini, shaken, not stirred.
Bond. James Bond. Look at you.
Thank you
so
very
sharp.
Much.
Wow.
Thank you.
Just there, yeah.
Thank you. Oh. Guys, I was wondering, I know we said it'd be the four of us tonight. Do you think maybe we could just make it Jessica and me again?
Jessica and you?
Sorry, is that rude?
A little.
No,
Not at all.
The better we do our job, the less you should see of us, right? And personally, I'm loving this newfound confidence.
Okay, great. Well, I'm going to have a birthday party tomorrow night, so we can all hang out then.
Here, right? Come on, Blofeld.
Just remember that the one is often the person right in front of you.
Blofeld, I'm going to get a pretzel.
Mind if I join you?
Do I have a choice?
Oh, no.
What's her problem?
She looked genuinely appalled.
I give it a year.
Some matchmaker you are. You can't be cynical about love.
I'm joking.
Another admirer?
Yeah. Hard to keep track of them all right now, to be honest.
Why don't you, you know, give one of these women a chance? You should try settling down once in a while.
I tell you what, I'll settle down when you settle down.
I'm not settling down out of choice. I just haven't found anyone I'm attracted to.
That's what people say when they're scared to get their heart broken.
Well, you would know you're a pro.
I happen to be attracted to everyone, actually. Just not for more than one night.
Hmm. Oh, appealing.
Okay. Watch this.
Ooh! Boom! So slick.
Almost as slick as my idea for the cocktail tasting night.
You thought that was slick?
Oh, yeah. Slickest idea ever.
What?
You think you can do better?
I know I can do better.
Okay, then. Okay. Hit me with it.
No. I mean, you just stick with your little cocktail tasting.
No, I'm serious. If we're going to start working together, let's start working together. Trade secrets. Not bad.
No, trendy cocktail parties, just low-key, simple, romantic fun.
Ooh.
Plus, it's kind of sexy.
It is when I do it.
Yeah. Please.
Oh, come on.
You look like Bambi on ice.
Bambi? What? Can Bambi do this? Huh?
Oh.
Huh?
Oh.
Is that Bambi?
Not bad.
Yeah, not bad. Whoa.
How about this for an idea? How about last one past the blue line has to pay for ice cream?
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1. Wow.
Go.
You're such a cheater. Oh, my.
That's one way to stop it.
Yeah. You, owe me an ice cream. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Last night was fun.
It was fun.
I also haven't forgotten that you still owe me an ice cream, by the way.
I'm pretty sure you owe me an ice cream.
No, I'm pretty sure it's you that owes me the ice cream.
Okay, it's done.
Oh, no.
Ooh. Yeah.
Hello?
Nina, it's Jane and Mike. Do you have a minute?
Yes, 1 second. Hi, what's up?
We need a date.
A date? You want coaching?
A date, like for a wedding. With you and the prince?
You want me to marry the prince?
We just got the projected sales. If there were to be a royal wedding in this book.
You marry the prince, write your happily ever after, and get massive international distribution.
It's only been a few weeks.
Well, in your book, you had a woman propose to a guy within 3 days of the meeting.
Yeah, but coming through, we really need to make a decision soon.
Right.
This thing with the prince is happening, or?
Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely. Sorry. Just got distracted. It'll happen. Soon, I promise.
Great, because we need to make a decision about the book in the next day or so.
Okay, not a problem. Yes, I will get my happy ever after, and you will get your
Final chapter, ASAP.
Delicious.
Thank you.
Wow, thank you, you look wonderful.
Thank you.
Wow, look at this dress.
Now this is why I love my job. Aren't they cute?
So cute.
You know,
yeah. Hi, excuse Hello. Me. I need to talk to you.
Is it urgent? Jessica literally just arrived.
Yes.
Is everything okay?
No.
Why, what's happened?
The stars.
The stars?
Have moved in. It's bad.
Some stars have suddenly moved, apparently.
Stars can suddenly move.
Not according to the general laws of physics.
Ah, it's funny. You know, sometimes I think about that time when we first met and I gave you my card. And I often wonder, you know, what would have happened if you and I started chatting?
I was far too angry to chat to anyone that night after such a humiliating day.
Freddie, you're so funny. That's what I love about you. You're so funny. You ever notice how much we laugh together?
We do?
What I'm trying to tell you, look, I'm not saying this to boost your ego or anything, but, Freddie, you're so great. And, Freddie, I am...
All okay with the stars?
Not yet. Still working on it.
I was getting lonely out there. Come join me.
Of course, I'll be. I see what you did there. Thank you. Hello, my darling. I'm so sorry about that.
It's okay.
I'm
so sorry.
Okay. What are you doing?
Nothing. I'll be right back.
Ignore.
Freddie, I need to speak to you again.
Nina.
It's urgent this time. Please.
What's going on?
Freddie, you're making a big mistake with Jessica. You cannot trust her.
What do you mean?
She's a vacuous Manhattan socialite. She's just interested in you because she wants to inherit your kingdom.
How dare you? Who do you... And you've only been on 2 dates and you're just attaching yourself to him like some limpet and walking around his birthday party like you're his fiance, and I just think it's very suspicious.
No, what's suspicious is what you are up to.
What I'm up to?
Yes. What are you up to? Come on. Who are you really, and what is your whole game here?
My game?
Yes, what is your game?
I'll tell you my game. I'm Freddie's dating coach.
No!
What?
I'm his dating coach.
You hired a dating coach to seduce me?
No.
So what? You were just using a series of tricks to seduce me? Is that it?
No.
All of this, it was just a game? You know, the cocktail making, the double date, that was what? Just a series of traps?
Of course not. Jessica.
No.
Jessica!
No, leave me alone and don't follow me.
Jessica!
Edward? Edward, wait!
She's such an
idiot.
Wait. You were in Freddie all along.
What? No, I wasn't. I was just...
You were just...
I was trying to get a book deal.
What?
I wrote a dating book, and the publishers told me that they would only publish it if I was dating someone... impressive.
You're kidding.
I was trying to win Freddie over because of a book deal. I was never into him.
Oh, phew. I'm so relieved.
Okay. Good.
No, not good. Bad. That's the most unethical thing I've ever heard.
I know. Listen, I wasn't thinking it through. But
But then I thought, you know, maybe I could date him and I could teach confidence and I'll get my book deal. So it wasn't so bad.
It's so despicable.
Maybe you would have done the same thing.
I would never betray the trust of my client like that. Never. He hired you to help him find the love of his life, and you just sabotaged it.
I understand.
I don't think you understand nearly how terrible it is. It's horrible, okay? And you hurt me too.
How did I hurt you?
You went on a date with me while you were trying to seduce him.
What are you talking about, that double date?
I'm talking about us getting pretzels and going roller skating.
You thought that was a date?
As a date!
But you said trade secrets.
I was flirting with you, all right? Just like how you were doing when you just slunk off and were enticing me to follow you.
I didn't slink off anywhere.
Oh, you slinked.
I did not slink.
You slunk, okay? I've been around long enough to know a slink when I see a slink and to know a date when it's a date and to know when someone's giving me vibes or not.
I wasn't giving you vibes.
Either you have no idea what dating is or you are in complete denial.
There weren't vibes. Whatever this...
Wow, it's my mistake then. I'll see you around, Miss Bauer.
You're such a narcissist. There wasn't any vibe. I'm sure he has a vibe with everyone.
Oh, Nina, this is bad. This is all over the internet. I mean, you're trending on Twitter.
What?
Mike and Jane. The deal is officially squashed.
One second.
Freddie, wait.
Hi.
You okay?
No, I'm not. I'm all over Twitter. It's a PR nightmare. My mother called me and said I brought shame on my entire family and nation.
What about Jessica?
She thinks that you, Edward, and me tricked her into falling in love with me, and now I have to go back to Montrovia and marry someone I don't even love. Thank you.
I'm sorry. Damage control. Jessica, please don't punish Freddie for employing me. He is such a nice guy, and I wasn't coaching him. I was trying to sabotage you both so I could get a book deal. What? It's a long story, but the gist of it is that I am a terrible person. But he's not. He's so lovely, and he wasn't playing any games to try and get you. He was just being himself. Even so, I don't want to be with someone who has a dating coach. I wasn't coaching him because I was trying to steal him. But the Freddy that you like is the real Freddy. And he really likes you.
I don't know. I hate drama. And I've had enough drama in my life.
But he didn't cause any of the drama. I did. This is on me. Please don't punish him for something that I did. If you could just give him a second chance, please.
I'm sorry. I don't know. I just don't.
Thank you.
I am actually happy they're not publishing my book.
Don't say that.
I am. I don't think I made a difference in anyone's lives.
What are you talking about? You helped literally thousands of people fall in love. Thousands of your clients got married because of you.
I think they would have fallen in love and gotten married with or without me.
What makes you say that?
Look at Freddie and Jessica. Freddie didn't need anything that I taught him to make Jessica fall in love with him. He just had to be himself. And she fell in love with him anyway. I'm starting to wonder if my whole career is a total sham.
I really don't think so.
No, I think so. I think anything I taught them. I made a fortune teaching people tricks when all you had to do was be yourself. Be authentic and the right person will come along and fall in love with you. That's the only real trick.
You should write about that.
What?
You should write a final chapter about that, about this shameful story of you pretending to coach the prince while trying to seduce him and how it all backfired on you, but it ultimately taught you the real trick to finding true love.
Which is?
Be authentic.
We don't love people for the dating tricks they employ. We love them because, well, who knows what the magic ingredient is that makes people fall in love with each other. But we can't create it. Sure, we can trick someone into liking us for a night or two, but we can't make people love us. And that's wrong. What's more is I used all my dating tricks to try and seduce Freddie, the Prince of Montrovia, just to get this book published. But none of my tricks worked. Ultimately, what is the lesson of this book, aside from not sabotaging true love? Just be yourself. Be your brilliant, wonderful, quirky, unique self. And if you do that, true love will come along. What do you think? Already said they're not publishing anything.
Send it. Trust me.
Hi, Nina.
Hi, Freddie.
I just wanted to say thank you so much for going and talking to Jessica.
I'm not sure it did much good.
It did. She came back to me and we're engaged.
You're engaged?
When you know, you know. I actually wanted to invite you to our engagement party tomorrow afternoon.
That's very kind of you, but I...
Edward's gonna be there. He's gonna be leaving to London shortly after, but might not be too late.
Too late for what?
Come on. It's obvious that you two have a thing for each other.
Did he tell you that?
No, it's just my observation. It's clear as the light of day that you two are perfect for each other.
Congratulations, Freddie. I really am happy that you finally found your princess.
Thank you.
You really want to publish my book? Aspirational boyfriend in the online scandal, and it's a complete PR mess.
It really is. But we were both so thrilled with your final chapter.
Really?
Yes. We love how you laid out just how immoral, unethical, and shameful you've been.
Thank you.
And that final twist about how you know absolutely nothing about love and your clients only needed to be themselves. Oh.
We'll have a book launch tomorrow.
I don't know what to say.
Tell us how the story ended.
Oh, yes.
Now.
No, not Freddie and Jessica. You and Edward.
Me and Edward?
Yeah. You're totally in love with him, right?
Why is everyone saying this to me?
Wait, wasn't that what the final chapter was about? Well, how you realized your true love was right in front of your nose, but you were too ambitious, stubborn, and blind to see it.
Oh. I have to go. Hi.
Nina.
Freddy, where's Edward?
Oh, he's left already. He's on his flight back to London. Oh. Don't tell me you really are in love with him.
Congratulations, babe.
Thank you.
Hey,
and I'm happy, I am. It's just I never realized how much I wanted love until it had come and gone. It was right in front of me, Taz.
You'll get a chance at love again. You will.
What if I don't?
You will.
Nina, say something.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for coming tonight. It has been my dream since forever. I have to thank Jane and Mike for taking a chance on me. Thank you. And I have to thank Jessica and Freddie. Thank you for following your gut and proving how simple love can be. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't have a book to publish. Really, thank you for not listening to me at all. And Jessica, I am so glad that you gave Freddie a second chance. You know, it's kind of ironic that I'm promoting a book on finding. I've been doing this for 15 years. Go figure. Sorry.
Tell us about your next book. What will that be about?
Oh, haven't really thought about it yet. I don't know. Maybe it'll be about a woman who is so blinded by ambition that she misses her chance at true love. Sorry.
It's just, I don't know if it's very good. It's just so depressing. I just read a story about two very stubborn, cynical people who almost lost out on love. But instead, they find it in the end.
I don't know. That sounds, a little idealistic, no?
The best stories always are.
Wait. Don't you want to wait till the fourth date to kiss a woman?
You should just go for it.
Oh. guilty.